good morning if it's morning, good evening if it's evening, and good night if it's night. And a big, hearty, salam alaikum to each and every one of you that is listening now or will be listening in archives. I gotta tell you all, first, happy Friday. Happy Ancestral Friday. Let's make this an Ancestral Friday. Guys, I don't care how you do it. I don't care if you pray to it, if you speak to it, if you yell to it, if you sing to them. Today, I want you to take time and just give thanks to those peoples whose shoulders you stand on. As I sit here and contemplate the things that I've been seeing on the internet for the last couple of days, I am taken aback and it gets me to start thinking, and it gets me to start praying, it gets me to start rejoicing in this thing that we call ancestors. Man, my Ferifung Egung, you are right, Ifa Abeyu. Guys, I've said this a million times, and I'm going to say it again. No one has control over your ancestors but yourself. I have ran over, and I have seen people doing things that are not, in my imagination, are not possible. I see people making ancestral oils. Well, first of all, let me say this. I love the fact that everybody is trying to get into ancestors. I love this. I love that the fact that people are embracing their ancestors, are finding out who they were, are pouring libations to them, are speaking to them, are singing with them. Some people even dance with them. But with this newfound spirituality, because it is a new phenomenon. There is a new phenomenon going on where everybody's talking about ancestors. And I love it. I absolutely love it. But with this is going to come the shams, the scams, the appropriators, the fakes, and the false prophets. Now I'm going to get back to why I'm saying this. Because I see people selling things that they call ancestral, okay? Ancestral oil, for one thing. And I asked this question today on social media. I said, well, whose ancestors are you buying? Are you buying the person's ancestors that is selling this oil? Or are you buying your ancestors back from this person who is selling this oil? You understand? Because no one can give you that connection to your ancestors other than yourself, your father's sperm, your mother's womb, and of course, the umbilical cord that holds everyone else together. Yes, I did say it, umbilical cord. That's why I often tell people to take care and protect their belly buttons. But that's for another day. Let's break it down like this here. The closest thing that you have to your ancestors is yourself and that water that you place on your ancestral altar. Now, do you have an ancestral altar? Oh, you don't. You don't have an ancestral altar, but you're buying oil from this fool that's selling ancestral oil. See, your first step is to make an ancestral altar with one cup of water, just one. And with that cup of water, with that beautiful cup of water, see, because there's only one thing that connects us all, which is the water that we drink. The water that runs, the water that's falling from the sky, the ocean. See, our bodies are consistent or made of water. So, if you really want to connect to your ancestors and you want some type of ancestral talisman, an ancestral oil, as you may say, use the water on your ancestral altar. You want some ancestral oil? Or whatever. Take you some whole, take you some olive oil. Pray over it. Put it on top of your ancestral altar. Speak to it every day just like you would speak to your ancestors. Voila! Ancestral oil. You want to make an ancestral a talisman and you can't get to your ancestor's grave? Huh? You can't get to your ancestor's grave. You don't have anything that might have belonged to your grandmother, your great-grandmother, whatever, 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 whatever. Simply put it on top of your ancestral altar with some water that you've already prayed over, that you've already elevated, that you already put to the highest place in the house and brought back down unto that altar. Once you have it there, just take that little thing, dip it inside that ancestral water, and put it on. Give it to your children, give it to your aunties, give it to your mother, give it to everybody. What? Guess what? I just made you a fucking ancestral beast. But Lord, please leave these internet buffoons alone. The closest thing to you and your ancestors is yourself. Conversation, prayer, dance, and music. And what covers all, or goes all inside of all of us, of course, is water. My Ferefung Egu, Bobo Egu. I'll be right back.
Toro, peu toro, lagba, lagba, peu toro,
Guys, you were probably wondering what this tirade was about, but let's just go on to the other thing. As I sit here today and I got, you know, a whisper from one of my spirits, told me that gut feelings are simply ancestral and umbilical cord warnings. But I asked Spirit, I said, man, can you please, you know, explain that to me a little bit. What do you mean by that? And he says, well, you misunderstood it. I meant to say that gut feelings are simply maternal ancestral umbilical cord warnings. And I sit back and I said, goodness gracious, that is so deep. See, guys, and I often tell people that they must protect their belly buttons at all times. Why do I say this? Well, because it was your first connection to ancestors, to your mothers, to nutrients, to air, to everything. So it is important that we protect that part of our bodies. It is important that we remember that cord that connects all of us. It is important that we respect and protect that cord that respects all of us. Now, I'm just going to give you a little time for you to go ahead and think about that, because sometimes the things that I say feel even a little bit too deep for me, and then I come back into it and say, oh, okay. That's what Spirit meant. Remember, guys, it is Egun Friday. Your ancestors are listening. So go ahead and dance, sing, or pray with them.
La 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 e chola, la 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 e chola, chola con tanta manilla, y yo no tengo dinero.
La 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 e chola, la 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 e chola, chola con tanta manilla, y yo no tengo dinero.
La 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 e chola, la 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 e chola, chola con tanta manilla.
Yvette the Motown Witch, why aren't you dancing?
La 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 e.
I see Ifai Bayou was over here doing a thing. And Giselle Baez LeBron. Mama Star is listening to us straight from Conjure New Orleans.
Chola con tanta manilla y yo no tengo dinero.
La 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 e chola, la 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 e chola, chola con tanta manilla y yo no tengo dinero.
La 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 e chola, la 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 e chola, chola con tanta manilla y yo no tengo dinero.
La 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 e chola, la 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 e chola, chola con tanta manilla y yo no tengo dinero.
La 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 e chola, la 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 e chola, chola con tanta manilla y yo no tengo dinero.
La 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 e chola, la 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 e chola, chola con tanta manilla y yo no tengo dinero.
E chola con tanta manilla
y yo no tengo dinero.
Chola con tanta manilla
y yo no tengo dinero.
Chola huengue con tanta manilla
y yo no tengo dinero.
Chola con tanta manilla
y yo no tengo dinero.
Chola con tanta manilla. cada manilla.
Y yo no tengo dinero.
Mamá chola con tanto dinero, manilla de oro, sin cuerpo sin nada.
Mamá chola con tanto dinero, manilla de oro, su cuerpo sin nada.
Mamá chola con tanto dinero, manilla de oro, su cuerpo sin nada.
Mamá chola con tanto dinero, manilla de oro, su cuerpo sin nada.
Mamá chola con tanto dinero, manilla de oro, su cuerpo sin nada.
Mamá chola con tanto dinero, manilla de oro, su cuerpo sin nada.
Mamá chola con tanto dinero, manilla de oro, su cuerpo sin nada.
Vamos a
saltar, mamachola, mayumbe,
langubacore.
Vamos a saltar, mamachola, mayumbe,
langubacore.
Vamos a saltar, mamachola, mayumbe,
langubacore.
Vamos a saltar, mamachola, mayumbe,
abri yumberawe.
Vamos a saltar, mamachola, mayumbe,
langubacore.
Vamos a saltar, mamachola, mayumbe,
mamachola, langubacore.
Vamos a saltar, mamachola, mayumbe,
langubacore.
Vamos a andar, mamá chola, mayumbe.
Chola wenge, a wenge chola. Chola wenge, a wenge chola.
Chola wenge, a wenge chola. Chola wenge, a wenge chola.
Chola wenge, a wenge chola. Chola wenge, a wenge chola.
Chola wenge, a wenge chola. Chola wenge, a wenge chola.
Hey, chola wenge, a wenge chola. Chola caminando.
Chola wenge, a wenge chola.
Hey, chola caminando.
Chola wenge, a wenge chola.
Hey, chola caminando.
Chola wenge, a wenge chola.
Hey, chola caminando.
Chola wenge, a wenge chola.
Chola caminando.
Chola wenge, a wenge chola.
Mama chola, chola caminando.
Chola wenge, a wenge chola.
Chola, chola caminando.
Chola wenge, a wenge chola.
Mama chola caminando.
Chola wenge, a wenge chola.
Chola wenge caminando.
Chola wenge, a wenge chola.
Chola wenge caminando.
Chola wenge, a wenge chola.
Chola caminando.
Chola wenge, a wenge chola.
Niña linda, niña linda, niña linda, la mamá chola.
Niña linda, niña linda, niña linda, la mamá chola.
Niña linda, niña linda, niña linda, la mamá chola.
Niña linda, niña linda, niña linda, la mamá chola.
Niña linda, niña linda, niña linda, la mamá chola.
Niña linda, niña linda, niña linda, la mamá chola.
Niña linda, niña linda, niña linda, la mamá chola.
Niña linda, niña linda, niña linda, la mamá chola.
Niña linda, niña linda, niña linda, la mamá chola.
Niña linda, niña linda, niña linda, la mamá chola.
Niña linda,
la mamá chola.
Niña linda,
la mamá chola.
Niña linda,
la mamá chola.
Niña linda,
la mamá chola.
Niña linda,
la mamá chola.
Niña linda,
la mamá chola.
Mamá chola, mamá chola,
Birindingo te está esperando,
Birindingo te está esperando, Birindingo te está esperando.
Mamá chola, Birindingo te está esperando,
Birindingo, Birindingo, Birindingo te está esperando.
Mamá chola, Birindingo te está esperando.
Mamá chola, chola wenge, Birindingo te está esperando.
Mamá chola, Birindingo te está esperando.
Chola wenge, wenge chola, Birindingo te está esperando.
Mamá chola, Birindingo te está esperando.
Birindingo, Birindingo, Birindingo te está esperando.
Mamá chola, Birindingo te está esperando.
Birindingo te está esperando, Birindingo te está esperando.
Mamá chola, Birindingo te está esperando.
Birindingo, mamá chola, Birindingo te está esperando.
Mamá chola, Birindingo te está esperando.
Niña linda con tanta manilla, con tanta manilla, yo sin ninguna.
Niña linda con tanta manilla,
con tanta manilla, yo sin ninguna.
Niña linda con tanta manilla,
con tanta manilla, yo sin ninguna.
Niña linda con tanta manilla,
con tanta manilla, yo sin ninguna.
Niña linda con tanta manilla,
con tanta manilla, yo sin ninguna.
Niña linda con tanta manilla,
con
tanta manía.
Mamá chola, yo sin ninguna.
Niña linda con tanta manía.
Manía, yo sin ninguna.
Niña linda con tanta manía.
Mamá chola, yo sin ninguna.
Niña linda con tanta manía.
Mambe.
Yo.
That was Lucas Brandoli with his group Barancón. I want to send a quick shout out to everyone who's listening to us in their prospective shops all over the United States and all over the world. I really don't have a prospective list on everyone because the list would be long, but I want to send a quick shout out to Yvette the Motown Witch and at YvetteTheMotownWitch.com, which listens to us in her beautiful shop every single day in Detroit. I want to send a quick shout out to Ifai Ibeyu at Love Supply Botanica in beautiful New York City. I also want to send a quick shout out to Mama Star Casas, everybody's mama, and everybody loves mama at Conjure New Orleans. I also have a young lady at Misty's Mystical Candles who listens each and every day. I love you, hun. I love your candles. And I can't wait to receive my batch of Candelo's Reversible Candles. Yes, they are on their way. Our thoughts and our prayers are with everybody in Hawaii, because they had a hurricane bearing down on them yesterday, and it's probably still today. But I want to send our prayers and our thoughts to our friend RK Gomez, who listens to us each and every day. I don't even know whether or not he still has light. Last time I saw it, maybe 4 or 5 hours ago, he still had lights on his island. But hopefully everybody is safe and well. We're gonna send good vibes, good Reiki, good ancestors, good everything to the islands of Hawaii, and hoping that everything comes out good. Well, let's not say hoping. Let's say we're gonna know that everything's gonna be fine. Well, guys, I got to tell you that I found a lovely story for the day. It's going to be a little bit long, but I think that it's needed, okay? The story is from Langston Hughes. Langston Hughes was a gentleman who wrote, an African-American gentleman who wrote The Invisible Man. Did you know that he also wrote short stories? This one is called Thank You, Ma'am, by Langston Hughes. She was a large woman with a large purse and had everything in it but a hammer and nails. It had a long strap and she carried it in a slung across her shoulder. It was about 11 o'clock on that night and she was walking alone when a boy ran up behind her and tried to snatch her purse. The strap broke. With a single tug, the boy gave it from behind. But the boy's weight and the weight of the purse combined caused him to lose his balance. Instead of taking off in a full blast, he had stopped. The boy fell on his back in the middle of the sidewalk. And his legs flew up and the large woman slippery turned around and kicked him square in his blue jean sitter. Then she reached down and picked up the boy from the shirt and shook him until his teeth rattled. After the boy said, pick up my pocketbook. After that, the woman said, pick up my pocketbook, boy, and give it here. She still had him, but she bent down enough to permit him to pick up her purse. Then she said, now ain't you ashamed of yourself? Firmly gripping him by the shirt. The boy said, yes. The woman said, what did you want to do for it? The boy said, I didn't aim to, she said, you a lie. By the time two or three people passed and stopped and turned to look, and some stood watching, if I turn you loose, will you run, asked the woman. Yes'm, said the boy. Then I won't turn you loose, said the woman. She did not release him. I am very sorry, lady, I am very sorry, whispered the boy. And your face is dirty. I got a great mind to wash your face for you. Ain't you going to go home and tell you to wash your face? No, ma'am, she said. Then I would get it washed this evening, said the large woman, standing up in the street, dragging him frightened little boy. He looked like he was about 14 or 15, frail, with a willowed wild in tennis shoes and blue jeans. The woman said, You ought to be my son. I will teach you right from wrong. At least I can do it right now and wash your face. Are you hungry?
No, said the being dragged boy.
I just want you to turn me loose. Was I bothering you when I turned the corner? Asked the woman.
No, ma'am.
But you put yourself in contact with me, said the woman. If you think that contact is not going to last a while, you got another thing coming. When I get through with you, sir, you are going to remember Miss Luella Bates Washington Jones. Sweat popped out the boy's face as he began to struggle. Miss Jones stopped and jerked him around in front of her, but put him in a half Nelson neck hold and continued to drag him down the street. When she got to the door, she dragged the boy inside, down the hall and into the large kitchenette, furnished room in the rear of the house. She switched on the light and left the door open. The boy could hear the other roomers laughing and talking in the large house. Some of the doors were open, too, so he knew that the woman was not alone. The woman still had him by the neck in the middle of the room. She said, "What is your name?"
"Roger," answered the boy.
"Then, Roger, you go to that sink and wash your face," said the woman, whereupon she turned around and let him loose at last. Roger looked at the door and looked at the woman, looked at the door, looked at the woman, and went to the sink. "Let that rudder run until it gets warm," she said. "Here's a clean towel." "You gonna take me to jail?" asked the boy, bending over the sink. "Not with that face. I wouldn't take you anywhere," said the woman. "Here, I'm gonna get you home to cook me. I'm sorry, guys. Here, I am trying to get home to cook me a bite to eat, and you snatch my pocketbook. Maybe you ain't been to supper either. Late as it be, have you? There's nothing home at my house. There's nobody home at my house." "Then we will eat," said the woman. "I believe you're hungry, or you've been hungry, or you wouldn't be trying to snatch my pocketbook." "I wanted a pair of blue suede shoes," said the boy.
"Well, you didn't have to snatch my pocketbook to get some blue suede shoes," said Miss Luella Bates Washington Jones.
"You should have asked me, ma'am." The water dripping from his face, the boy looked up at her. There was a long pause, a very long pause. After he dried his face, and not knowing what else to do but dry it again, the boy turned around and wondering what was next. The door was open. He could make a dash for it down the hall. He could run. The woman was sitting in the middle of the daybed. After a while, she said, I were young once, and I wanted things I couldn't get." Then there was another long pause, and the boy's mouth opened. Then he frowned, but not knowing, he frowned. The woman said, "You thought I was going to say, but you didn't. You thought I was going to say, but I didn't snatch purses and pocketbooks."
"Well, I was gonna say," pause, silence, "I have done things too, which I would not tell you, son, neither tell God, if he didn't already know. So sit down a while I fix you something to eat. You might run a comb through that hair too. You look so unpresentable." In another corner of the room, behind the screen, was a glass plate in an icebox. Miss Jones got up and went behind the screen. The woman did not watch the boy to see what he was going to run now, nor did she watch her purse, which she had left behind her on the daybed. But the boy took care to sit on the far side of the room where he thought he could easily see him on the corner of her eye, if she wanted to. He did not trust the woman, nor did the woman trust him, and he did not want to misintrude now. "Do you need something to go to the store?" asked the boy. "Maybe I can get some milk or something." "Don't believe I do," said the woman, "unless you want sweet milk yourself. I'm going to make cocoa with this canned milk I got here." "That will be fine," said the boy. She heated some lima beans and some ham she had in the icebox, made the cocoa, and then went to the table. The woman did not ask the boy anything about where he lived or his folks or anything else that would embarrass him. Instead, they just ate. She told him about her job at a hotel beauty shop that stayed open late night, what the work was like, and how kinds of women came in and out, blondes, redheads, and Spanish, to cut their hair in tens of cakes. "Eat some more," she said. When they finished eating, she got up and said, "Now take this $10 and buy yourself some blue suede shoes. The next time, do not make a mistake of latching on to my pocketbook, nobody else's. Because the shoes have come by devilish, it will burn your feet. I'm going to get some rest now, but I wish you would behave yourself, son, from here on out." She led him down the hall and through the front door and opened it and said goodbye. "Behave yourself, boy," he said, looking out into the street. The boy wanted to say something other than "thank you, ma'am," to Miss Luella Banks Washington Jr. Jones. But he couldn't do so as he turned at the barren stoop and looked back at the large woman at the door. He barely managed to say thank you before she shut the door, and he never saw her again. This story is by Lanston Hughes, and it's called "Thank You, Ma'am." Hope you enjoyed today's reading. Guys, if you have any short stories you would like to listen to me read or anything like that, just go on ahead and send them to me. I love them. I hope that you love them too. I'll be right back.
When I wake up in the morning, love, and the sunlight hurts my eyes, and something without warning, love, bears heavy on my mind. Then I look at you, and the world's all right with me. Just one look at you, and I know it's gonna be a lovely day. Instead of me, always seems to know the way. Then I look at you, and the world's all right with me. Just one look at you, and I know it's gonna be comfortable affair. And when someone else instead of me always seems to know the way, then I look at you and the world's all right with me. Just one look at you and I know it's gonna be
day. I hope that all of you are liking this beautiful Friday, this beautiful ancestral Friday. I hope that everybody is having a good time and that is going to be doing what they need to be doing. Speaking, dancing, praying, loving, connecting with your ancestors. That's what we've been talking about today. I really want, man, people to get a better understanding of this and not all that crap that's going in and around the internet. It's not the right way. It's not the way that I was taught. Okay? It is not the way that I was taught. I was taught simplicity, mini culta, small things. Small things. Shit. Man, you don't need to get a 50-carat gold plate to offer your ancestors anything. You know, they are happy that you're communicating with them, that you are uplifting them, that you are speaking to them. See, because there's a lot of earthbound spirits that people don't even talk to anymore. A lot of people don't even remember. I sit down sometimes and I wonder to myself, why are people speaking on or speaking to other people's ancestors? Even the spirit of what some people want to call Jesus or Nefertiti. I see people taking on names of Ra or some other thing, when there's nothing closer than your ancestors. There is no other link to anything that is not your ancestors. Ancestors first, ancestors third, ancestors last, and then you can go to your gods, your goddesses, your whatever, on a stick. I don't care. But let's sit down and have a real conversation with grandma, with great-grandma. Let's have a real conversation with uncle, auntie. Let's have a conversation with them first. And then after we have that conversation with them, we can go to everybody else. But it is important that you do not leave them behind. You got it? And since some of my ancestors were coconut pickers. Yes, coconut pickers. I'm going to play this right here.
Yabo kushikwa na humala kontumwoni. Baba Pikuzo Mani Nani Uleni Nani. Aye.
Kimango sinachwe moyo keke sinizwe unga Nishani na nsumeno itindao mbele na nyumba
Ayango maya, ayango maya, ayango maya
Oya ee, mishani
Ayango maya,
mishani na nsumeno itindao mbele na nyumba
Ayango maya,
kimango sinachwe moyo
Kurora ngoma si hata kangia katika vina Engoma Engoma Ngoma Yeo ngoma Kesho ngoma Nantondo ngoma tena
That song is called The Coconut Picker's Song. It's made by various artists. I don't know exactly where it's from, but again, it's called The Coconut Picker's Song. I have a little bit of love for that weird kind of eccentric music, but nevertheless, it is always spiritual. Guys, I gotta tell you, we're coming close to the deadline. I forgot to tell you that our people at Ritual Craft are hosting a wonderful event this year. Well, they're not hosting, they're promoting a wonderful event this year, and it's called the Mile High Conjure Gala. The Mile High Conjure Gala will be held in beautiful Denver, Colorado, in a beautiful haunted mansion, or inn, that is called the Lumber Baron Inn. The Lumber Baron Inn has been voted one of the 7 best inns in the United States. And guess what? It's also haunted. Beautiful home. I had the pleasure of staying there last year, and I'm going to have the pleasure of staying this year again. The Mile High Conjure Gala is one event that I honestly tell you that you cannot miss. It is a meeting, a caravan, an influx of people from all over the United States who come down on the Lumber Baron and teach hoodoo, root work, spiritualism, music, and teach everything and have courses on how to do magic, on how to divine, and do all these things. Guys, join Professor Porterfield, Professor Ames, Beverly Smith, Michelle Jackson, Miss Aida, Ambrosine Laguerre, Miss Rains Conjure, Yvette the Motown Witch, Ifa Ibeyu, and myself, your host for this wonderful event at the Mile High Conjure Gala, Candelo Kimbisa. Go on over to the MileHighConjureGala.com, get your tickets. And if you're a seller and you want to vend something, go ahead and get yourself a vending table. Believe you me, you'll have a great time. Well, guys, I want to tell you that I'm having a great time with you this Friday, but I gotta go because I got two more readings to go and I am free for the weekend. But I gotta tell you, I do feel damn good. But anyway, as always, may all the air wounds and shadows that accompany you have all the necessary light. From where I sit, that's it. Now, let's remember Grandma.
Most of us at some point in our lives have somebody that means more to us than anybody else has ever meant before or will ever mean again. Sometimes it's a long-legged lady if you're a man, or some tall, very smooth man if you're a woman. And in some odd cases, they get kind of crossed up. We won't talk about those. But in my case, I learned how to really love somebody from not a very pretty lady, not at that point in her life, not sexy at all, but just a nice old lady who used some very nice old gnarled hands to make life kind of nice for me at that time when I really needed somebody. And it wasn't after I got older and started to look around for things. It was before I even knew what I was looking for. And probably since I consider myself somebody who writes primarily, out of all the things that I might have written, my favorite thing that I've written has to be about this favorite old lady of mine. Grandma's hand clapped in church on Sunday morning. Grandma's hand played a tambourine so well. Grandma's hand used to issue out a warning. She'd say, Billy, don't you run so fast, might fall on a piece of glass, might be snakes there in that grass. Grandma's hand. Then Grandma's hands soothed the local unwed mother. Grandma's hands used to ache sometimes and swell. Whoa, Grandma's hands used to lift a face and tell her she'd say, baby, Grandma understands that you really love that band. Put yourself in Jesus' hands, Grandma's hands. Then Grandma's hands used to hand me a piece of candy. Grandma's hands picked me up each time I fell. Whoa, Grandma's hands, boy, they really came in handy, she'd say. Matty, don't you whip that boy, what you wanna spank him for? He didn't drop no apple core, but I don't have grandma anymore. If I get to heaven, I'll look for grandma's hand.
It's 12 o'clock somewhere was brought to you by Kimbisa.org, Love Supply Botanica, Conjure New Orleans, and Lil Omi and our ancestors.